Hey guys, so it's been a while since I came on a video, especially showing my face. So the reason why I'm doing this video is because there are a lot of people who are viewers of the channel, and these guys, please ignore the background noise. The crows are having a, you know, yearly party here somewhere. So anyway, so I'm saying a lot of our channel subscribers actually really want to buy something, but you know, money is a big challenge. So that was a challenge for me as well at the time I started my DIY journey. So today, by you know, the hard work and the people around me, I am able to actually buy certain things without worrying about money. But there was a time when I had difficulties, so I'm kind of going back mentally to that time, and I am actually trying to raise money in such a way that I can ultimately buy a bike, a super bike, without any money invested. So the plan is pretty simple. You know, I'm not going to go for any Ponzi schemes. I'm not going to start an Amway dealership, or you know, I'm not going to cheat anybody out of their money. So my plan is very straightforward and simple. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a list of spares that I have, which I don't use. So then what I will do is those spares will be listed on, it's kind of a garage sale, and then what I'll do is I'll raise money. Now the question that you guys might have is, oh, I don't have spares, what will I do? So in such a scenario, I'm going to make this challenge a bit difficult for me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sell some stuff, make some money out of it, buy some stuff, then sell them again. And when I do the first buying, what I will do is I'll take the initial investment money that I have put out of this equation, and I will only use the profits which have come from the sales to buy the next set of stuff. Okay, so this is a plan. So in simple English, if let's say we are planning this, what we are going to do is, let's say we have 5 rupees with us. Okay, I'm just giving you an example. So for 5 rupees, what can I buy? So maybe I can buy, let's say, maybe a soap. Okay, and I have to make sure that I have to get it cheaper than the market rate. So let's say this soap sells for 5 rupees or 7 rupees. I have to make sure that I get it for 5, and then I have to make profit, which is I have to sell it at 7. I have to find the right buyer, and once I sell it for 7, I have a 2 rupee profit which I will take out. I can either withdraw my principal immediately, or I can roll it to a time wherein I have enough money to buy enough of the next stuff, and then take out my profit, I mean principal. So it's a very simple thing. So certain ground rules. I'm not going to you know, inflate the prices of things beyond what it is already selling for. So what I will do is I'll try to sell it at the market price, or maybe a little less. Okay, so that is my aim. So when you do such a thing, you have to, you know, understand how you will find the market rates. So market rates, finding market rates is not that difficult. You have to look through a, you know, combination of platforms like, you know, OLX, Facebook Marketplace. So we will look at such combinations, and we will try to gauge the price at which things sell, and based on that we will price our items and we will sell them. So that is the plan. And you know, there is one thing that you always need to understand: what is junk to you might not be junk to anybody else. So there is always a buyer with a lower budget than you, so you can sell almost anything that you have. And we will start the journey like this. So another thing which is for you to understand is, this thing might not happen in a day. You know, you might not have money to actually buy a super bike in a day. So this might have to be repeated multiple times and might take us over a year to complete this. So I want some of you guys to join this journey along with this video. So I want to give you guys an assignment wherein you will also buy such things, and you are also able to sell it and make a bit of profit. And understand, if you know you are selling something which is cheaper than the market price, it will definitely sell faster. But at the same time, you have to also make sure that you make a reasonable profit in that. If you don't, then it is going to be a huge loss for you. So my next point is, buying stuff is not difficult. You will get them pretty easily. There are certain places that you have to visit, which I will also show you guys, like, you know, places where there are junkyards, workshops. So, you know, we will primarily focus at bike stuff, but we can also look at other stuff. Maybe, you know, some of you might be gadget freaks. So for a gadget freak, something like a gadget would be more interesting. You guys will understand what is the price. So I have some subscribers who like gadgets a lot. So those guys, it would be good that you do the same things with gadgets. Like, say for example, you know have, let's say, an old, really old phone. So you sell it for, let's say, 2,000 rupees. So now you have 2,000 rupees in the kitty. So using this 2,000 rupees, you might buy something which is sellable at maybe 3,000 rupees. So you buy let's say another phone, sell it for 3,000 rupees. Then the next thing that you will do is you will sell this phone for 3,000, and then probably buy another phone for 5,000 rupees, and this thing goes on. Okay, so that's how we are going to reach the magic number which would make us buy a superbike. First of all, right now we haven't decided what superbike we will buy, but it will be a superbike. Okay, so that is one. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take an inventory of stuff that I have. So there are a lot of stuff that I have which I don't use. Last week I sold like 20 rims and tires for like 50 bucks. So my aim was to clean, you know, the garage, but then you cannot do that if you want to make a profit. Like 20 rims for 50 rupees is going to be a very stupid thing to do. So what we will do is, we will take out all the stuff that we have, we will make a list of the things that are lying idle, and let's see if we can sell some of those. Okay, so I'm not going to sell anything which is majorly important for me, like carburetors, carburetor parts, CDIs, etc. But there will be a lot of stuff that can come out of my inventory. I actually have a lot of stuff lying. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take out all these sellable things, and I'll line them up, and then probably we can decide what we can sell and how much we can sell it for. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. All right, so these are the spares that I have, which I can let go immediately. I have much more spares, but these things I am not going to use in the near future or in a future which is little far. So I thought of letting these go. So those are a set of rims that came with one of the RX that I had. There is a slight chip, but that is okay, because even in my RX 100, it was running perfectly fine. So I think those alloys I can let go for around 3,000 rupees or maybe 2,000. Then there is a Fiero F2 rotor that we can let go for 500. The proton chamber we can sell for 3,000. There is no problem in it, apart from what you see there, that can be repaired easily. Then there is an RX 100 6-hole silencer which broke, so I got it repaired, and it is in fresh chrome. So what you can do is, you can use it as is. So this thing is around 1,000. We'll sell it for 1,000 rupees. Then we have a Shogun silencer, OE silencer. This thing we'll sell for 2,000 rupees. Then we have an RD 175 mudguard, which is cut and shaped as per RD 350. This came from my bike, so we can sell it for 500. Then these forks, we can sell it for 1,500. The RxZ tank is the big ticket item, so that will be sold for 6,000. Then we have this old stock RX100 type mudguard with the hole on the top. So this we can sell for around 500. This is newly painted, but it got scratched since I kept it in my storage. Then we have an RX100 head that can be sold for 500. We have a used chain sprocket from RD350 that can be sold for 500. Mask I will sell for 2000 bucks. Then this Continental GT mudguard with the strut brace would be sold for 500. Then I have this seat grab rail thing for 500 again. The entire body kit for 1000. So these have some damage repair, like the side cover has some damage. The engine guard needs a small piece, so that can be done. This is the original tail panel that came with the Kashmir bike. So it has one broken tab here, and plus this is broken. So I'm looking to see if I can sell it as a set. I also have a mudguard which I forgot to put here. So that also will go. So yeah, that are the spares which I'm planning to let go immediately. So this overall thing can at least raise me around 22,000 rupees. And then probably we can start our hunt for our next stuff that can make us money. So this 22,000 that I will raise from here will be pulled in and rolled for a couple of times, and then I will pull that 22,000 off from the kitty, and we will use whatever profit we have to continue forward. So yeah, so we will let go these stuff. So yeah, that's the okay list. So you saw we have quite a few items to sell. So approximately we are planning to raise about 20,000 rupees out of all of these stuff, and once all this is sold, we'll use that money to buy the next thing. And then what we will do is we will slowly take our initial investment out, like the 20,000 that we are planning to start with. I am not going to actually wait for the entire 20,000 to come. If it is selling in parts, maybe, you know, if I get 5,000 to 6,000 rupees, I will definitely invest that money in something else, and then we'll sell that. So this is going to be an ongoing series. This is going to take at least a year. So I want you guys to be very patient. Let's not try to rush. Good things come to those people who are patient. So that is the aim and motivation. If you guys want, it is great that you guys can go on this journey with me. If you also have some spares and you know, lying unused, if you have anything, you know, which you don't need and you want to sell, remember there is always somebody with a lower budget. So try to sell it and use that money to buy other stuff, and let's start the ball rolling. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed what you liked, and I hope there are many things that we can do. And this is primarily aimed at people who have the passion to do things and to achieve their goals. Saving money is not going to be easy, you know, especially in these times. So it is always better that we generate income rather than try to take money out of our existing revenue stream for a hobby like this. So this is going to be a pure play generation of income, without cheating anybody, of course. The prices that I have mentioned here are all negotiable to a certain extent. These are not going to be like, you know, something which is advertised for 3000 won't sell for 1000 rupees, because our aim is to make profit. So the rates are reasonable, and if you guys feel that you are a little low on budget, probably I can reduce maybe, you know, 100-200 bucks, but the ultimate aim is to get around 20,000 rupees from the whole lot. The things that I have posted are highly sellable. Those are not things which do not sell that easily. So hopefully we can, you know, make money quickly, but let's hope we can give it time. We don't have any hurry as such. So once everything is sold, we will start buying the next set of stuff and flip that. So that's the plan. My idea is to do some something big so that the whole thing becomes little faster. That's why I am raising a little bit more money. You can start the whole thing with much lesser money, like, you know, maybe 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees. So, but you just need to know what you can buy for that money to make profit. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, like, share and subscribe, and we will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.